Alright, hello everyone, this is the one, the only, the Phenome, and welcome back to my Starcraft Remastered playthrough series, part 24. So, in the previous video, we continued on with the Protoss campaign for the original Starcraft, and in that mission, we went to Risky Circle, who you will be familiar with if you watched my Starcraft 2 playthrough, or if any of you played Starcraft 2 before. The Dark Templar leader, and we succeeded, even though there were so many Zerg in the way, considering how small our group was, and those friggin' infested Terrans. Bane of my existence in that mission. Blew up so many good dudes, and yeah. Was rather tough, but in the end we pulled through. There were some saves coming, I have to admit. But yeah, in the end we got through, and now let's continue with the next campaign. With the next campaign, with the next video. No, not the next video as well. Next mission. There we go. It took me 3 tries. I'll get there. Okay, so we did the mission Into the Darkness, and now finally we are ready to go into the mission Homeland. So let's see what it entails.
Greetings, Executor, and greetings to you, Tassadar. I am overjoyed to see you both return home in this dark hour. The Zerg have redoubled their efforts, and it seems...
It can't be. The Executor told me of how you fell before the Zerg. How is it that you live and breathe?
Well, after my unfortunate defeat, my ruined body was recovered by our brethren. I now reside within the cold, robotic shell of a Dragoon.
Old friend. Would that this never came to pass.
Nonsense! There is no shame in defeat, so long as the spirit is unconquered, and I am still able to serve Aya to a degree. But enough of this. There is much you both need to know. You have been branded as traitors by Alderis and the Conclave. Even now they seek to arrest you and execute the Dark Templar, Zeratul.
I never believed that they would go so far. In the face of total annihilation, they still cling to their failing traditions.
Yes, and that makes them all the more dangerous. They hunt you even now, Tassadar. And though I damn myself by doing so, I shall stand by you till the end.
And Tarawadun, noble Phoenix. Executor, it seems that if our world is to live, we must protect the Dark Templar from our own brethren. Not even the Conclave shall stand in our way.
Alright then, so the objectives are to destroy the heart of the Conclave, and Phoenix, Zeratul, and Tassadar must survive. So, a bit of a rough one. Looks like we're going into a bit of PvP. Protoss versus Protoss. Protoss observers are great for scouting. They remain permanently cloaked and can detect hidden units. Okay.
Executor, you and the traitor Tassadar are to cease your resistance and surrender yourselves to the judgment of the Conclave. We will take the outlaw Zeratul into custody and deal with him as is written by the Collar's Law.
Flee back to your masters, Alderis, and huddle with them in darkness, for your actions shall send us all unto the Zerg.
Observer. So we have a walled in base. That's pretty good. Oh, right. Macro in the first Starcraft game. This is gonna get interesting. This is really gonna get interesting for you. Right, I need to have a little look. Okay, so there's the macro. Aha, we do have a shield battery available. So that's what I'm gonna build. Okay, is it really too far away? You gotta be kidding me with this range. Well, that's lame. Geyser here. And it's got 4,500 gas, so shouldn't be too bad. Alright, get in there, little fella. That should be okay for now, I would say. So, let's start working on our troops. Alright, what do we have here? Air upgrades, ground upgrades. We have our gateway. I guess we'll get another probe out. And, oh, hello. Alright, DTs. Get in there. Oh, they did have an observer there. So let's get another cannon in here. I wonder. Okay. These shield batteries are pretty worthless, to be honest. So instead, I'll just build more cannons. Get rid of the shield battery for me as well. Nice. I think it's Zeratul who's smacking for like... Yeah, he's got like double damage compared to the other Dark Templar. Alright. One cannon there, one cannon here. Should be good enough, I think. Let's see. Also, guys, so we don't have any scouts in the air. So let's rectify that by getting four of them out. Actually, I'll get a couple more probes. Right. So, I don't think I have Templar Archives. Nope, I do not. Here we go. Seem to have a robo either, so let's get that going somewhere over here so units don't get stuck. Singularity charge, yes, that will be useful, and plasma shields. Like, I don't know what the proper way of doing things is, but I always prefer to take the shield upgrade. It just feels the most versatile. Alright, so we have a robo and an observatory that we can build after we're done with the facility.
I hope you be successful. Standing by, it will be done. Zanashkulina, very well.
Alright, so Unit 4 is going to be my DTs. Gotta be careful with those. Okay. So, we have the Templar Archives. I need that for something, but I don't have any space on what it actually was. Oh yeah, of course. High Templar here. So I can't actually build DTs yet. Which is interesting. I can sell clinics. Not even sure, to be honest. But let's get some more probes.
Cheers.
Okay, so Robo's up. So shuttles, reavers, and observers. Alright, so let's get the observatory up so we can get more observers. We have air
command.
Okay, nice and easy. Luckily, scouts attacking is really not an issue. Oh, hello. Hello, Strange. Let's try and scare him away. Oh, come on. Probably not doing this right. I probably shouldn't be focusing on scouts, but I mean, there's no other air that I have, and I do love the mobility that air units allow for. Right, let's shore up our defenses. Go a bit ham on the photon cannons. I know that they're fairly expensive, but actually gonna get a pylon up on this side. Okay, looks like another observer is up, so I'll just float around and see what I can find.
Successful upgrade complete.
See if I can maybe find a natural. Okay, let's go here. I do remember this mission does take a while. Okay, so there's my natural. Oh my days, that's so much stuff. Oh boy, look at all that cheddar. Okay, so that looks very nice. So I'll send the observer back to base for now. Alright, I may have wasted a lot of minerals on that, but you know what? I don't mind. Actually, let's send this probe over to the natural. Maybe start building up there.
Contact.
Right, so, yeah. lots of scouts in the air, just in case they actually have carriers in their base, because BA likes to mess with you like that, take higher tier units for itself, when you don't. Scouts would be pretty effective to deal with them. Alright, let's drop that Nexus. Drop pylons as well, straight away, so I can build up defenses ASAP. Let's get the simulator up in there as well. If I can build up quickly enough to basically recoup all the costs that I had for this natural expansion, should be okay. Okay, pylons are up. Very nice. Alright, the simulator's up as well. Now we just need to wait for the next building. I'll drop one in here as well. Should hinder the Vespine gas gathering. Okay, Ken's almost up. Oh, I can hear the sounds of fire. Saturate to the max this expansion, just in case when I run out of minerals here on my main, I can just send all these probes over to do some extra work there. But what I actually need to do as well, I need to start working on my army here. Move out. So they annihilated this area, which is annoying. Let's go get some minerals from here. And let's go drop some more cannons. I mean, I did get rid of those reavers fairly quickly, but actually I think I do need to work on my air weapons. Because the scouts are gonna... Unfortunately, they're going to be my most important defense against the Reavers. Actually, what I need is an observer that I'll attach to the... I'll attach to my scouts. Let's see, does it work? Yes, it does. Okay. So now I'll just upgrade the observer from my advanced sight range. That should be pretty good. Alright, let's get some more dragoons here. Alright, Julio, get out of there, little probe. Otherwise you'll get blown up like those cannons. Alright, let's actually get another observer out. Oops, not shuttle, and observer. There we go. And you little fella, you're gonna go scout for me. Let's see what we can see. That's pretty decent sight range already. I think I need to, like, clock these attacks, especially with the Reavers. I need to clock them again very early, otherwise, it's just not gonna be good. Okay, so there's walls, and there is a photon cannon. Another photon cannon, okay. So, that's the first base of our amazing post. Alright, I'll just preemptively send over my scouts there because they might be attacking. Might attack the Reavers there. Because there's a dragoon and another dragoon. Now go away. Go back, yeah, there we go. So, that upgrade is complete, so observers are now moving to go.
It will be done. Locus acknowledged. Chaos.
Locus acknowledged. Okay, looks like we have another red base over there. So let's send back our scouts. Let's get another scout into the unit there, actually. A couple more. So I have a proper air force.
Ugh.
I'll just send in the DTs to clear out the middle. Show me if there are any observers in the area.
I'm waiting.
Aha, there is. Alright, meanwhile, we have a nice force of dragoons here. I'll get a couple more. What about the robo? Could use shuttles to fly in.
Complete. Standing by.
I'm not sure on that. Yeah, let's get rid of this guy. Oh, that's a carrier. I friggin' knew it. Their observer. Hopefully, the only observer that they have here. And now we can clear out these dragoons in the middle. So I have three. I'm good on gas, and I'm actually good on minerals at this point, but, I'll just, keep upgrading. Speaking of upgrades, anything else I can really get here? I probably should be getting Templar and Psystorms, but at this point, when you're not fighting Zerg, it just doesn't feel worth it. Or even, like, I guess when fighting Terran, it doesn't feel worth it. It does feel worth it, but not when fighting Protoss, like, because they don't attack with that kind of mass numbers. Right. Alright, what do we have here? Another scout. Okay, that's down. So yes, actually, as I mentioned, my suspicion was confirmed. They did have carriers.
Yes, executive.
Yes, needs more observers. So, what else can I find out about this base? So, photon cannons here. I mean, I think I can afford to go in. If I actually kill the base, I can't afford to just go in and lose most of my stuff and then rebuild it. I have the resources for it. Aha, so that's a brown base. Oh, come on. Make it easy, photon cannon. Come on, don't be like that. So yeah, Robo Bay. That's so it's sitting there. So I'm assuming this will be the big base that I need to clear out. Dragoons on walls, all that kind of stuff. Interestingly enough, no observers, but I can tell. Oh, yeah, heavily fortified entrance. Yep, that tracks. And then there's a red base over here. Is that? Oh my god, that's an Arbiter. Kidding me? This prick just stasis 9 of my 10 scouts. Are you kidding me? That's pretty silly, not gonna lie. Freaking Arbiters. How long are they going to sit in stasis, by the way? That's quite a while. Okay, looks like I need another cannon. Another couple of cannons, actually. Air upgrades for my cybernetics core. That's a buzzkill. Right, let's actually get Zealot legs. So we have shields. Well, shield upgrade number 2. Oh, these are 2-2-2 all already. So I can get the tier 3 shields. Nice. I'm actually gonna get another forge, just to expedite the process. Actually, you know what? I'll just clear out those dragoons in the middle with my zealots.
Honor guide me.
Fine.
Thus I serve. Honor guide me.
And clear out the observer scouts. Of course.
Standing behind man calls. Contact. Teleport successful. Locus acknowledged.
Okay, you bastard, get over here. Oh, come on, how is it that fast? Kill that scout. Wait, is that a...
I long for combat, Shogun. Chaos. Love is acknowledged.
Ah, I had to split them. Why did I split them? The thing is, I can't get Arbiters at this point either. So they can get Carriers and Arbiters, and I can't. Oh my days. That's a lot of stuff. I'll actually dip out with my, scouts. Right. Shuttles, the observers.
We are under attack.
Oh my god, run you fools.
We are under attack.
God, there's another Arbiter here. You've got to be kidding me. This is just absolutely ridiculous. In fact, this guy's just flying around, just stasing, just putting everything in stasis. Another gateway out. Like, I can't really move forward because, everything's just being put into stasis and I can't do anything. Hey, buddy. I want to talk to you. The fact that they get on all these units, they get on groups. Oh no, you don't. Yeah, I need to move out.
Contact.
I just need to move out and get rid of this base. Yes, Arbiter down. Okay, Pesky Geyser is depleted, but I think these guys can still gather. Yeah, two gas per geyser. Alright, I have four scouts against two, so I'll just back off. Fly back to my towers. That's another Arbiter down. Yeah, you better run, sir. So yeah, I need to clear out those bases ASAP. Get some zealots. Okay, ground weapons and ground armor going up. I actually have three shield upgrades. I mean, they do have high Templar, which is concerning. I still should be able to handle them. I'll actually get another gateway up. So three gates, and that way we should be able to produce quickly enough. Okay, I think actually I don't need that last one. Alright, forges are working. I'm sticking. I guess I might as well build a support bay. I just really hate using reavers. I just find them way too clunky and it's way too easy to again, just a quick check. Yep, no air unit upgrades.
What would you ask of me?
Gosh,
you address me. How may I help?
I'm really excited about taking my heroes into the fight as well. Actually,
my life for I.
I'll get another 12 zealots out, just in case. Where's that probe?
My life for I.
Oh, right, I sent it over here. I'll just get more pylons in, just in case.
My life for I.
Alright, so I'll have two full. Actually, I'm gonna save up to two full units of zealots. Hopefully, by that time, they'll do another reaper attack so I can clear them out, and then I'll go off on the offense. Let's see if I can snoop around their camp a little bit more. So that's an observer. Aha, they are sending a full on attack. Okay, air attack thwarted.
My life for ire.
Let's see about their ground forces, if they're sending anything. Well, there is a high Templar here. Should be a pain. Yeah, I'll just park my observer over here.
My life for ire. She comes.
Yeah, they killed the observer. Hey, buddy. Don't get away that easily.
Lucas acknowledged. Will be done. Upgrade complete. Upgrade complete.
Let's get another observer out. Okay. We should have. Yep, another result is coming out. So. This guy's. Five. Alright, so. I know this is probably not the best way to. Not the best look for me, but I will save. We'll save there. Get my dragoons out. And yeah, the scouts are actually, like. At this point, they're the most important part of my army. So, we're gonna go after that first. That base on the left first.
Standing by.
passes out. Let's work on 2-2 upgrades there.
Standing by. What now, Claws? For a duel. Receiving. Jogan.
That's a lot of stuff that they have. Okay, I thought three gates were enough. Not nearly enough, it seems. Let's destroy the space as quickly as possible. Alright, that nexus is destroyed. Oh my days. They are attacking my base again. And I didn't shore up my defenses. I didn't have to involve DDs. Finish off this base. More zealots on the way. How are our upgrades? Looks like we're ready for 3-3.
Your warriors have engaged the enemy's instructions.
Okay, have we cleared everything out here?
attacked. What is he? What happened to the sands?
Are you kidding me? No. That's not how we're gonna do this.
I long for combat. Loss I serve.
Okay, six more zealots on the way. After that, let's get some more dragoons queued up. Actually, yeah, some backup and some backup zealots as well. Okay, so that was an attack wave. So we need to clear out this other red base before we assault their main compound. I'll just leave an observer here. So it can tell me if they're actually trying to do something funny. Alright, get some more scouts. So this time they shouldn't have any backup coming in through the back. Oh, also, I do need to shore up my defenses just in case. I do apologize that this is stretching out so much, but I haven't played a proper macro game in Starcraft for a long time. So, yeah. Probably, as you can see, I'm not the best at it, but, yeah. We're getting there. I mean, the end goal is still to finish this campaign, finish the Brood War campaign, which I'm absolutely dreading right now, because it's gonna be tough stuff. It's gonna be tough stuff for someone like me, who's more of an aesthetic, person. Oh my! Okay, they actually just smashed through my defenses here, so I'll just build up the cannons here just in case. Come on! Alright, so they sent a dragoon over there. I don't mind. Waste as many forces as you want. Alright, dragoons are going to have a hard time going through this bridge, so just get them as close as possible. Scouts. Now let's get in here. Yep, that dragoon is now falling back. That's Reavers right there. So let's get in there. Okay. just assault towards the ruler here.
Executor, Eldaris, this madness must stop. The sight of my brethren slaughtering one another is more than I can stand. Though I fear you would doom us all, Eldaris, I surrender myself to the conclave. End Taro Adun, Executor. Don't give up the fight.
Wait, what?
Tassadar of the Templar. By your actions, you have severed yourself from the mercy of your brethren. You refuse to destroy the Terran worlds as was commanded. You have questioned time and time again the sacred will of the Conclave, and you have abandoned your home world in its darkest hour. Most grievous of all is that you have allied yourself with the blasphemous Dark Ones, and learn to utilize their profane powers in tandem with our own. What say you, O fallen Templar?
Eldaris, I submit myself to the Conclave's judgment. Would know this. Given the same choices again, I would surely have made them. I have sacrificed all that our world might live. I have sullied my honor. I have discarded my rank and standing. I have even broken our most ancient traditions. But never think that I would for one moment regret my actions. For I am Templar, and above all else, I have sworn to protect our homeworld till the end.
So is that gonna be it? That is gonna be it. Wow, okay. So why was I so... Well, yeah, I mean... I really shouldn't have even bothered then thinking about the orange base. I should have just gone straight to the red bases and gotten rid of them, and this video could have been cut down by about 20 minutes. Anyway, we do have victory. We do have victory here. Let's see, in terms of units, yeah. In terms of kills, I think I did a pretty good number on the other... on my enemies there. In any case, that will be it for this video. So in the next video, we'll see what happens. I mean, Tassadar was sort of the spearhead of the whole effort here to defend Ire, and now he's given himself up to the Conclave. So that leaves the Executor, that leaves Phoenix, and that leaves Zeratul on their own. So yeah, in the next video, we'll see what their actions are going to be. As for this video, that'll be it. So yeah, thank you very much for watching.